Good morning from Disney's Grand Floridian Resort. It's a cloudy day here in Central Florida, but I think it's gonna get nice and hot later. It is President's Day at 9:30. I have a reservation at the Grand Floridian Cafe. I am late for it. It's currently 9:30, but my reservation's at 9:15, and they made me park kind of far away. So off to check in for my dining reservation. I think I already said it, but it's President's Day today. I am off work. My full-time job is Monday through Friday, and so I never get to really come to the parks on the weekdays. So I took President's Day as an excuse to have fun at Disney today, and I'm so excited. They checked me in for my reservation that was like 15 minutes late. And now I'm just sitting down, relaxing. It is seems like it's going to be a very, very busy day at Magic Kingdom, which it's a holiday as to be expected. But when I was walking in today, the queue or the line to get into the parking was so long. I can't believe how long it was. I haven't seen it that long in a long time. So I know it's gonna be very busy today. I'm still sitting here, and it's now 10:05, and I got here about 9:35, so I've been waiting a little bit, but I think it's pretty busy, so hopefully I'll get sat soon. I got sat right after I said that, and I have a very pretty view. I'm right in the back room of the Grand Floridian Cafe, so it overlooks like all of the grounds. So pretty behind me. Here's my view. It's not very nice outside because it's still pretty cloudy, but pretty view of all the flowers and buildings. I got my coffee, but I made a mess. I spilled the cream all over the place. This is what you get to start off at the Grand Floridian, which is really nice. You get biscuits and a citrus butter, which is actually really good. My food has arrived. I got the lobster eggs benedict with the cheesy hash brown casserole. They tried to give my plate to someone else, but they got it to me. That looks really, really good. Yeah. The other thing I got, because I can't have a Disney breakfast without a Mickey waffle, I got two little sides of Mickey waffle. There is nothing better than a Mickey waffle covered in butter and syrup. Yum.
Now it's time to go to Magic Kingdom for a little bit. Breakfast was really good. I had the lobster eggs benedict, which were very good, and then had a Mickey waffle, and that was delicious. But I'm not actually too stuffed because I only had one waffle and I didn't really finish my entire entree. So it was a good breakfast. Now I'm going to take the walking path to Magic Kingdom and kind of count how long it takes so you guys can get a good kind of visual or representation of how long that it takes to get to Magic Kingdom. Okay, I'm starting on the walk. The path kind of starts right by the quick service at the Grand Floridian. Ooh, I think it's raining. Yikes. Maybe I should wait a little bit.
There was a little bit of a rain, but I think it's just from a dark cloud. So I'm gonna take a chance and walk. It's so cool when the monorails come past you on this walk. I love this walk. It's perfect. We are almost here. This walk was so pleasant when it's cloudy. Look how cloudy it is, but it's so nice out. The breeze feels so good. So when you walk, you come where the boats get dropped off, and that's where you go through security. just right up to the right is where I'll go through security. Here we are. It does look a little busy. I haven't really seen turnstiles this long to enter in a pretty long time. Pretty surprising to see this since I'm not used to this. The walk here from the Grand Floridian took 14 minutes. And I didn't walk like super fast, but I also didn't walk slow. It seemed like a lot of people are having problems getting in. People still must not realize that you need to make your park pass. Pretty busy in here. The line to get into guest services is so long. Let's check out the train or the fire station. They took out Sorcerers of the Magic Kingdom, and now the fire engine is on display in here. Engine number 71. This is cute. Firehouse Open House, engine number 71 welcomes you. This has always been really cool to me because firemen are in my family. My grandpa was a fireman, and then my aunt's brother was a fireman and he died in a fire. So fighting fires is definitely special to my family. I just love all of these different fire badges in here. It's so cool. I have seen this before. I wish I would know if there was a fire badge from where I'm from, which is Toledo, Ohio. I wish I would know if there was one. Look what I found! I found it! Toledo, Ohio, which is where I'm from. I got the badge! That is so cool. They must turn the Emporium entrance all around. This is the entrance. Normally, there's only one entrance that's at the front. I'm gonna go check to see what the Emporium has. Here's some new pins I wanted to get. Ow. Oh, I just stubbed my toe. Ow. This one is Alice. And then the one above it is Beauty and the Beast. I collect Beauty and the Beast pins, and that is like the coolest pin I've ever seen. They're not limited edition, but they're really big too. I also just found the sweatshirt I want. This is the sweatshirt. I was trying to find Def Cup, but they did not have my size. I love that. It's so cute. This is a whole selection of this retro yellow Disney logo, Walt Disney World logo. They have a lot of stuff. They have the yellow t-shirt, the Crocs, and you can see the Crocs have that logo on the side. And then they have the spirit jersey, which is up there. This yellow hat, this water bottle. And then they have the coffee mug, and then they have a blue hat with the logo. This is all so cute. I just love all this. I have to show you guys these. These are Corksicle, Mickey and Minnie. A little pricey, $40 for Corksicle, but I love how they're bringing in like quality brands instead of kind of like their cheap, like no-name brands. Just because you know the quality you're getting, these are really cute. This is what happens when it starts raining. People start pouring in. And it was just coming down pretty hard. it actually looks really cool out right now because there's the dark clouds behind the castle. I wonder if there could be a rainbow because the sun is kind of out behind me. So pretty. The rainy day cavalcade is coming. I have not seen this in a while. Sun like right now, but when the sun comes out it gets very hot and humid, but it's not awful. It's definitely not summer, but it has a little bit of summer feels to it. Everything seems really busy. Look at this line for Buzz Lightyear. It's 60 minutes right now. The queue goes all the way back into Monsters Inc. last floor. I am actually going to do Carousel of Progress. It's been a long time since I've done that, and the line looks pretty long, but I'm gonna wait because I really want to go on it. I think Carousel of Progress is a 20-minute wait right now. I'm not sure. I'm in line, and you can see it goes all the way back there. This is actually kind of comical. Yikes. Here we go. I think it was probably about 20 minutes. They put you on these numbers, so I was 6. And then you go in the room, and you must have certain numbers already. So you must just follow your number.
If you do not think you can stay for the entire 20 minutes, we ask that you please exit now and return at a later time. Once again, please choose any open row with any open seat. Rows 2, 4, and 6 are not available. If you have more than 4 people in your party, you will have to...
Welcome to Walt Disney's Carousel of Progress. Oh, you're in for a real treat. The Carousel of Progress was Walt's own idea from beginning to end. He loved it. He introduced the show at the World's Fair in New York City in 1964, and it was an immediate smash hit. Millions of people came to see it. And since then, the Carousel of Progress has had more performances than any other stage show in the history of American theater. You know, Walt loved the idea of progress, and he loved the American family. And he himself was probably as American as anyone could possibly be. He thought it would be fun to watch the American family go through the 20th century, experiencing all the new wonders as they came. And he put them together in a show called Carousel of Progress, which we are now about to see. Although our Carousel family has experienced a few changes over the years, our show still revolves around the same theme, and that's progress. May the century begin.
There's a great, big, beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great, big, beautiful tomorrow.
Great, big, beautiful tomorrow, shining. shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, just a dream away.
Well, it's another Halloween here in the fabulous 40s. Everything is better than ever now, and we've got some amazing new wonders around the house to prove it. For instance, our refrigerator holds more food and ice cubes. And thanks to our automatic dishwasher, I don't have to dry the dishes anymore after supper. Gives Rover and me more time to enjoy our evening stroll together.
Tomorrow, shining at the end of every day, there's a great big beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow's just a dream away. Man has a dream, and that's the start. He follows his dream with mind and heart, and when it becomes a reality,
it's a dream come true for you and me. So there's a great big beautiful tomorrow,
shining at the end of every day.
There's a great big beautiful tomorrow,
just a dream away.
I have no idea where these lines are for. I think this is for Space Mountain, but I'm not sure. I don't think that they will be able to increase capacity until the 6 feet restriction goes down, because there's no way that they can make these lines any longer than what they are right now. Yeah, Space Mountain line continues. Here's a little glimpse of the crowds right now. It's a very busy day here for COVID. It's still not busy for before COVID, but it is a little busy post-COVID. The lines are long, it's a little crowded, but it's also like the peak of the day right now. So, this, I mean, you can still maintain 6 feet from people, but you just have to maybe try a little bit harder. But this is the line for Winnie the Pooh. You can see it's very long right now, which is kind of the theme today. Here is walking past the Seven Dwarfs Mine Train. The Pooh, I just passed, is 35 minutes. Let's check the mine train.
The worst one?
Mine train is 95 minutes. Yikes. Okay, I'm about to kind of film a very busy spot. This is kind of like the biggest traffic jam in all of Magic Kingdom. So don't be overwhelmed, but this is the busiest part of the day, and this is normally the busiest area in Magic Kingdom. You can see all of the strollers, lots of strollers, and it's very warm right now. I'm sweaty. So let's see what this looks like. Again, like I just said, this is normally the busiest area with the bottleneck at Magic Kingdom. And then when you bring in the extended lines for rides, it can look a little overwhelming. I still feel comfortable here, but again, I've been going to Disney at least 2 or 3 times a week since it's opened, so I'm fine. But some of you that aren't really used to these crowds, I guess, might think it's a little much. And it actually doesn't look that horrible up here like I thought it would.
Thank you.
It's really not actually too bad in this area right now. I think the Liberty Bell Riverboat is available right now to be on. So I'm gonna jump on the riverboat because I have not done it yet. And there's Tinkerbell. Yay, I'm excited to go on the riverboat.
Right one.
Hi. I definitely want to go on the up floor, but I don't know if I can because I can find some spots. Whenever this quick service is open, Aunt Polly's is my favorite. I think we are about to go. Yes, this feeling just came up. And we're starting to move. That's kind of funny. And you can see the crowds, and I'm not in those crowds right now. Still fun, even though it's crowded. I just panicked because a big bee was chasing me, a huge bee. And I thought it was gonna sting me. watch the show, but my husband does. Wanda 50s, black and white. And then Vision 50s, black and white. And then there's Halloween versions. Those are pretty cool. I really like these black and white ones. That's pretty cool. There is a new magnet here. Look at this St. Patrick's Day magnet with Mickey and Minnie. That is so cute. Ready for my mobile order like 10 minutes ago and it's still not ready. Hopefully it shouldn't take too long. Here's the craziness for Dole Whips right now, a little bit closer. You see so many people are in this area waiting for their Dole Whips. I think this may be the end of my Disney day after I get my Dole Whip. It is very busy here, a little too busy for me. I'm used to the crowds, but it's just, I don't need to ride anything. I don't really want to wait in any lines. So I'm probably going to head out right after I get my Dole Whip. My order was ready at 1, and this is the line to get in for 1. Super long right now. Here is what I got. I got the Carcamora float. Coconut saucer with pineapple juice with blue curacao and chocolate Carcamora cake pop. Thank you. Alright, here is my Carcamora float. You can see the blue curacao, pineapple juice, and then the coconut, and also this really cute cake pop that I probably won't even eat. That Carcamora float is so delicious. I didn't remember liking it that much until I just had it. I could have literally had 2 of those. It was so yummy. These trees are popping up a lot in Orlando. I don't even know what kind they are, but they're these yellow trees, with yellow flowers. They're so pretty. There is some construction going on right in front of the castle. So these, I don't even know what you call them, planters or something. Not sure what they're doing, but this just went up today. Still beautiful. So pretty. So here, right in the hub, is a completely different experience. There was just that debacle mess. Oh my gosh, this little girl's so cute. There was just that mess with Dole Whips. And now it looks just so nice here. It's not that many people at all. I think it's just all about like certain times of the day, there's different bottlenecks. And Dole Whip at 2 or 3 p.m. when it's really hot is a huge bottleneck. Especially in like a crowded place. It's not that bad here at all. The van just passed again and it is time for me to leave. Too long for me here in Magic Kingdom. Still not too crowded in this area. Goodbye from the front of Magic Kingdom. Thanks so much for following me along on my wonderful day off work. A nice little break from the weekly grind that I'm gonna have. A fun day at Magic Kingdom, although a little busy and hot. But any day at Disney is fun in my book.